Ayensu Starch Company Limited, otherwise referred to as ASCO, was established in 2002 with the capacity to process over 22,000 metric tons of cassava starch per annum. To meet its objective, the company assisted various farmer-based organizations within its catchment area to produce cassava by providing them with resources, both financial and technical, to ensure a sustainable supply of its raw material needs. Mr. Speaker, as part of the efforts to sustain its operations, the company entered into a two-year off-taker agreement with Guinness Ghana Brewing Limited to supply 14,000 metric tons of industrial starch until June 2015. Under the agreement, Guinness Ghana provided the company with financial and technical support. Mr. Speaker, the government in August 2016 offered 70% of its shares in the Ayensu Starch Company to Tiberius Company Limited, a company which is affiliated to the Josmon Group of Companies. Mr. Speaker, Tiberius Company accepted and made an initial payment of $2,269,500, representing 51% of its $4,450,000 obligation as a purchaser. And since then, Tiberius has made no further payments. The company has failed or refused to fulfill its obligations under the purchase agreement and has defaulted on all other revised payment schedules. Furthermore, the company has abandoned the factory and left the workers idle and without compensation. Mr. Speaker, in the light of these and other developments, the Ministry, through the Transaction Advisors, PwC, informed the company of its decision to take over the Ayensu Starch Company in a letter dated 20th December 2018. The company, however, in a letter dated 14th January 2019, indicated its refusal to hand over possession to the Ministry, although the company has abandoned the factory, putting the plant and machinery at risk. Mr. Speaker, we are currently seeking legal advice on the next line of action to take to restore the company to government ownership. Mr. Speaker, in anticipation of a smooth takeover, the Ministry is negotiating a package under the One District, One Factory program to resuscitate the company to ensure that it achieves its intended purpose of job creation, reducing rural-urban migration, and producing a very important raw material for the food and beverage sector and other related industries.